outside the cow's edge.
Good. Where's the? Where's our officers?
Where's Robert?
Ah, she's.
It's where we're going to. There, the water's cascading.
Good lads, well done, thank you.
Cheers.
I'm sure
you're
relations, please.
Thank you.
All right, ladies, go back onto the park, dear. Can we have all the friends now, please? All the friends?
Friends!
Over there. I'm sure you agree all the efforts have been more than worth it. for being here. The rest means a lot after the year we all had last year. So we have you all here celebrating with us. I'd now like to present the bouquet to Jill and say thank you for that with you. So I'd like to thank them both for all the support they've given us from the very start. They've always been there for us whenever we've needed them through the good and the bad times. And I'd also like to thank them for everything you've done for making today possible. Right, now for my mum and dad, I'd like to congratulate you on raising such an excellent, handsome and open performance day. I want to thank you for all the love and support and encouragement you've given me throughout my life, which made everything I've done possible. So, Ian, I'm especially grateful for giving us a day like today that we'll never forget. I'd like to present my mum with a bunch of flowers, which will hopefully go some way making up for the ones we dug up, but it's not. Toast,
toast to both of our mums and
dads. Thank you very much. Well, mate. We'll also say how lovely all the bridesmaids look today. Thank them. That's all that they give being here on time. We're not looking around outside for a fruit shop. We've got a few thank yous to say and a few little presents. We'd like to say thank you to Ian over there for all the play settings that he's done.
I'd like to start by saying when Gary first asked me for the best name, many things occurred to me. The duty, the honour, the pride, who else had turned him down? More to the point, could I refuse and still turn up for the free drink? It was a risk I was unwilling to take. That being the case, my first duty is to thank Gary for his kind words to the bridesmaids. I'd like to add my own appreciation of the young ladies, of whom I can only echo Gary's sentiments, that you all look absolutely fantastic. I'm sure it comes as no surprise, but still never less disappointing for all us single gentlemen to know that the bridesmaids today are all spoken for. It was one of my conditions. Bridesmaids arguing earlier outside the church about who was going to have the first dance with me. Understandable, I thought. So I got closer and heard them saying, "You, no, you." On the subject of the church, our thanks to Father Tom today. It was good to have a proper service as both Louise and Gary are religious and observe the Ten Commandments, albeit only five each. As we all know, Gary has taken his vows and commitments today very seriously. And although single, I'd like to think I was the source of some very useful advice in the build-up to the wedding. For example, Gary asked me, when getting married, should the couple be frank and earnest? One should be a woman, I suggest. Despite never being married, I feel I can offer advice of this calibre, as I've got a good idea what it's like to be married. After all, I did once try to get out of a book club. During this chat, I divulged all the information I knew about women and marriage. I clearly remember because it took up almost half an ad break on the TV. And we got a reason to get married, unless you've lost interest in it. Sheets, James is positively lethal. Foreplay is the key, I told Gary. The difficulty is finding another couple to make up the form. Dispensing priceless gems such as this must have been enormous assistance to Gary, and he seemed to take it all on board in his customary relaxed style. But then Gary and I have always been close, and along with Mark, we're something like the Three Musketeers. We're all of the same age, 31, so we grew up together, drinking from the bottle, crawling around naked, trying to walk, but more about the stag weekend later. We got ourselves into and out of some interesting scrapes, but it's all a learning process. For example, we learned it's actually a criminal offence to throw snowballs at moving police cars, But to be honest, I think that's some strange 18th century bylaw. Okay? As most of you all know, Louise and Gary have recently bought a new house, which does need quite a bit of work doing to. But Gary assures me it would be great when Uncle Christopher and Paul get their finger out and make a start. As Gary gave me the guided tour of the house, sharing with me his vision of just how he intends to put the rest of the family to work, he confided in me that when finished, he would be bossing the house.
Well done. Smile, please, smile. That's it. Lovely photographs. There's just a few.
My love, I'll never find the words, my love, to tell you how I feel, my love. Mere words could not
Behave. This one.